Texans.
That's right.
But he didn't give the will of the people or the House an opportunity on Friday. Instead, he acted alone and enforced his own will upon the process, bringing to a halt the efforts of over 100 co-authors and many thousands of individual Texans who have called, emailed, faxed, and rallied in support of this bill. Apparently, the Speaker thinks his wisdom is above 111 co-authors and even the entirety of the House when they voted unanimously to pass this bill. Given the duplicity of Strauss's position and the sudden break from his traditionally neutral stance on the Speaker's dais, it appears that the Speaker is staging his own publicity stunt. As a matter of fact, at the same time last week, Linda Harper Brown submitted a concurrent resolution asking humbly that the federal government rein in TSA. Now, 1 week from today, next Monday, we'll be celebrating the signing of the Declaration of Independence. In that document, our founding fathers stated that in every stage of these oppressions, we have petitioned for redress in the most humble terms. Our repeated petitions have been answered only by repeated injury. It's my opinion that Linda Harper Brown's request to the federal government in this concurrent resolution will be met with the same response that our letters to our representatives here in Austin have been met with. Now, are we laughingstocks because we want to protect a 95-year-old terminally ill woman who was yanked from her wheelchair, forced to remove her adult diaper after seeing her daughter for the last time? Are we laughingstocks when we try to protect our pregnant wives from having their breasts fondled in public? Are we laughingstocks when we try to protect our children from having their genitals touched? I think not. Texans think not. Now, if you're able to go with me to the Capitol when we're finished here, please join me on the rotunda, second floor west wing. Go to the pages desk and ask to fill out a message card to your member. Make sure that your representative is supporting House Bill 41, even if the House concurrent resolution is up as well. Tell them that you expect them to make sure it comes up for a vote. And if the Speaker won't let it, tell them they have to appeal. If he shoots that down, then let them know that you insist that they keep going. This is the people's house, has been mentioned several times today. It is not the representatives, and it is certainly not the speakers. And afterwards, you can then watch the proceedings from the gallery on the third floor, or you can head over to the Senate Transportation Committee hearing to register your support of House Bill 41, Senate Bill 29. Thank you for coming today. I'll see you at the Capitol.
Thank you all very much for coming. Oh, Barbara. Yes. Yes. Come on up here on the microphone. This is Barbara Mabry. From Austin, from
Georgetown.
Georgetown.
Yeah, not Austin.
I just wanted to let everyone know that I was in New Orleans weekend before last for the Republican Leadership Conference. Perhaps some of you were there. I had an opportunity to hear Governor Perry's speech. The applause was unbelievable. People there love him. They think he's fantastic. What I want to ask that we find some way to try to monitor his speeches. He said in his speech that he saved the rainy day fund, that it was not touched. So we really need to be careful that he, when he's out speaking around the country, that he is not being the typical cheerleader that he always is. So that was all I wanted to say, is that he is out there, people think he's fantastic, but they don't know the truth about Rick Perry. And I think it might be up to the grassroots to figure out some way that we can monitor his travels and what he's saying.
Right.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Barbara. It is important. That's why we're all here. We want to hold our elected officials accountable. We elected them to represent us and not the special interest groups. And I again want to thank you for being here. We will be here until 4 o'clock today. If there's people that come in, we're going to be getting statements from people. I'll have them on videotape. And if you are with the media and you're here, if you'll just please leave me a card so that I know who all was here, so we can be watching for your coverage. Ray, did you?
I just got one comment. I know there's media here. And I know Paul Burka is a popular man in town, okay? But we also have a best and worst list. So just letting you know right now that it's out there and we're gonna be talking about it, but we're gonna be talking about it privately. We're not gonna put it out there like Burka did, but we're gonna be talking and working and building profiles.
There you go.
One last thing that reminded me of, one of the things that I don't think our elected officials are aware of is that in Texas, the grassroots and Tea Party movement is active and on the ground all over the state. And we understand that in order to clean house in the Republican Party, it must be done in the primary.
Yes, ma'am.
And we are preparing, we are building profiles, we are letting our people know what the votes were in the House and in the Senate in Texas, and we will take action in the primary. Again, thank you all for coming.